To be honest, out of all of the gacha games I play right now, I'm probably most obsessed with Total Assault from Blue Archive. So I'm talking in terms of gameplay. Right now, for me, it's beating the open world exploration of Genshin Impact. In my opinion, it's a lot more fun than Clan Battle from Princess Connect. And as for Alchemy Stars, although Alchemy Stars is really fun, there's just something about this game mode, Total Assault, in essence, your raids, that really makes this game like really, really fun. And so in this video, I just wanted to take you guys through a hardcore raid, essentially what right now is the most hardest difficulty, and show you guys all of like the different micro and macro decisions that I make throughout these raids. Hi, welcome back to another Blue Archive video. My name is Lace, and today we're going to be doing a raid together. Unfortunately, I've only got a VOD of a raid that I recorded. I unfortunately couldn't do it in time before like the reset. And so I just wanted to go through this footage and kind of talk through like how I think when I'd go through a raid. And for you guys who are watching but are not playing Blue Archive, which may or may not be you, you guys can also like experience the gameplay vicariously through this video. And so maybe this will convince you to play, maybe not. Who knows? But with that being said, today we have hardcore Shiro and Kuro, and essentially this is a two-stage boss in which they are weak to blue. If I fast forward a little bit, you will see my team over here, which is predominantly comprised of blue characters. So I've got Haruna, Izuna, Chise, so Izuna, I know you guys are gonna look at Izuna, but I freaking sparked her. Izuna for me was like just so freaking cute, so I freaking sparked her. I didn't spark her because I thought she was good for the raid, I sparked her because she was freaking cute. But otherwise, as for supports, I've got Serena and Kotama down over here. And so from a macro level, a lot of this, I guess, makes sense. Like I said just then, Shiro and Kuro are weak against the blue element. And so we've got the Mystics, Haruna, we've got Izuna and Chise. And then Iori just comes along because she is so incredibly strong when she is standing still, which is most of the fight. All right, and so that's the team from a macro perspective. So for you guys who don't know, these are four DPS units. There is no tank here. And as you can imagine, the reason for that is because you want to clear the boss ASAP. However, depending on your levels and your gears, this may not actually be possible, but this team is what I use to one-shot the hardcore mode. As for down here, we've got Serena and Kotama. So Serena is a healer and Kotama is probably one of the best supports. In a nutshell, Kotama will pretty much juice everybody and like boost their attack by a crazy amount. On the other hand, I've got Serena the healer because I just am unable to clear the boss without it. And so as you guys can imagine, as I get higher and higher in terms of levels, I will eventually maybe one day be able to phase out Serena in favor of more DPS. Alright, so that is the macro level. So I quickly go through the gears, but essentially I have about like 40s, the T4s, for most of my team, except for this one over here, Chise. And the reason that I have not juiced her out is because, well, she is going to be replaced very, very soon. Alright, and so with that being said, let's get into the raid itself. So I did have to do this a couple of times simply because I'm like a, I'm a freaking noob, but like, let's get it over here. Alright, so this should be a good one. So essentially at the very start of the round, I will reset until I get the desired skills I want down here. What I really want is Kotama, which is this unit over here, and the reason is because I want her buff to be cycled as much as possible. And so what you will notice when we go into the fight is that I will drop that Kotama buff almost immediately. So as you can see, I'm about to pick it up and then I drop it on top of all of my characters. It gives, I'm pretty sure, like 40% attack to all of them for the next 30 seconds, something like that. And then from here, there are a couple of different things I do, some good, some bad. For Izuna over here, I select her because I want to increase her attack speed by 39.7% for 30 seconds. However, I have this really bad habit of like placing Izuna like away from everybody else. And as you guys saw from the beginning of the video, I drop my Kotama buff on all of them. And so if I like place her somewhere like over here, then she's not going to be able to get the Kotama buff. Alas, that is exactly what I do. I'm pretty sure I like fly her somewhere else, but apparently not this time. So it looks like I decided against it because of these drops over here, these bombs. And so instead I just activate my Iori skill so that she can just do a lot of damage, right? So bam, bam, and then one more bam over there. And then as you can see, look, this is my really, really bad habit. I really shouldn't be like placing her so far away from everybody. And then this is where the fat juicer is. So my Haruna deals 811% of attack damage to enemies in a straight line. So generally speaking, I will only ever use Haruna's skill when I actually have the buff from Kotama on her. And how I know that is from the times two over here with the sword icon. So this should actually deal like 99k damage if I'm not wrong. So that was 97k if I can find the frame for you guys over here. here. I just saw it. And so it's right here, 97046. Without the Kotama buff, she would not be doing nearly as much damage. I'm pretty sure it's about like 50, maybe 60K. And so it's at this point that you can see that Kotama has cycled back into our rotation. And thus we rinse and repeat and then playing some bit of like RNG as well as positioning. For positioning, it's really interesting because this guy, he does a whole bunch of stuff. And then at time 7 HP bars over here, he will then roll down the entire lane. And so that's a massive reason as to why I keep moving my Izuna over here, because I always try to move her out of harm's way. And so as you just saw, I did the Kotama buff on my Iori and Haruna, and Izuna did miss out on it. So that is certainly something that I do need to work on for my next raid. Anyway, so these random bombs over here, like I said, they are random. And we have hit time 7 over here. This is one of the predictable moves. And these repositionings is very much why I find this part, or rather this game mode, fun. Because there is so much agency here, right? Like I can position them, I can make them get away from like this rolling ball that he's about to do. So just watch this. He's a, oh God, here he comes. Ning, ning, ning. And then he switches lanes. So it's very, very much like an MMO, like learning a boss, right? Learning their attack patterns and then being able to incorporate what you have to ultimately deal with all of these mechanics and then hopefully get a good score. So he's about to switch lanes. And then so my Izuna can actually pop back into this middle lane. I should not have put her there. I should have put her closer to everybody else so that I could Kotama. And so she misses Kotama again. And so it's like all of these different mechanics that I really find like this game so fun, right? And so what we just saw was the boss falling off of his ball because he got stunned. Because throughout this entire fight, there was actually this accumulation thing over here. So if I go back a little bit, you see the yellow, and then as this goes higher and higher, it gets to a certain point in which he then like just breaks down and starts crying, right? So as you can see, boom, the yellow has disappeared and now he is on the floor, which is so freaking weird. So I made the Izuna mistake again, like, oh my God. But yeah, it's the combination of all of these different mechanics that really, really just makes this so fun, right? Like I got to pre-buff my Haruna before I use her UB, sorry, her skill to actually fire off at the boss. Got to hit that 97K every single time or else I am going to be losing damage, which is a no-no. My positioning of the Izuna, how I always just fly her off to nowhere, which is so dumb. And then now we have the second stage of the boss where the mechanics have changed a little bit again. And look, my Kotama and my Izuna, everybody gets the buff except for my poor Chise over here. And then as for this boss over here, as you can see, he has like the rotating teacups that are about to go do some vertical damage. And so some common ways to deal with this is to like get my Izuna to block the damage because the cup will stop after it hits the first person. And on the last raid, what I actually used was like I put down a shopping cart or something and then it blocked the damage. Again, it's all of these different things that just really, really makes this fun and exciting. I don't know. It's very addictive. I think, again, there are so many parallels to like the MMOs, to the boss fights. Learning a boss fight, I believe maybe Monster Hunter, they certainly do leverage these kinds of feelings, right? But essentially, that's really all I wanted to talk about in terms of raids. Like, I am really, really enjoying these raids, this Shiro and Kuro one in particular, because, well, the mechanics are quite simple. But the fact that we can do so many things, and so as you can see, I screwed up so I can just restart, and I have an hour to complete this raid. And within that hour, I can reset as many times as I want. Like this system, this reset system, really adds to it. It just means I have unlimited goes and it's just so fast to reset when something goes wrong like that. But yeah, I just really wanted to make this video because like A, I want to show you guys, the guys who are not playing Blue Archive, who are not playing these raids, I wanted to show you guys what the end game did look like. And again, it's pretty freaking fun. And then for you guys who are playing Blue Archive, I wanted to show you guys what I was doing. So either A, you guys may learn something from it, or B, you guys could critique me, tell me on how, like if I'm cycling skills wrong, if there are optimizations to be made, such as my Izuna, like my random dumping of my Izuna and not getting that Kotama buff just there. I know that there are a whole bunch of optimizations, such as like animation canceling or like don't animation cancel, just stuff like that, right? And it's not very often that you find a gacha that has all of these different mechanics, right? I think a lot of the time, like games like Arc Knights or like Alchemy Stars, there is kind of a set way to play it. And I'm not saying that like Alchemy Stars or Arc Knights, like they have worse or inferior gameplay. It's just that games like that, it's kind of like you have a puzzle and you're given these tools to solve that puzzle. For Blue Archive's raids, it just feels so much more like dynamic. There's a lot going on and every raid is like probably going to be very, very different. You can certainly rely on a lot more skill. And again, that's not to say that Alchemy Stars and Arcanites don't require skill. Like those low rarity clears, like They are so freaking mint. But yeah, there's just something so satisfying about like being able to position all of these characters, being able to cycle with like the correct moves, being able to block damage, being able to mitigate damage. And I think I've been sorely missing this because of all of the Princess Connect that I've been playing. And for you guys who don't know what Princess Connect is, it's effectively a lot of this, but 2D and a lot more auto. But yeah, that kind of sums up like all of my thoughts about this guy over here. I think a TLDR of this video is like, I like raids. I think you guys should give raids a shot, maybe even give Blue Archive a shot if you are not playing. And so with that, I don't think there's too much left to be said except for me passing on the question to you guys. I guess my first question would be, do you guys play Blue Archive right now? And if you already do, are you guys enjoying the raids? And if you are not a Blue Archive player right now, well, what do you think of all of this? What do you think of this raid? Does it kind of look exciting? There is a lot of micromanagement going on. Are the mechanics a little bit too much? Perhaps you're looking for something that's a bit more autoable. Whatever your thoughts may be, let me know down in the comments below. And I would really appreciate it if you do that because it means you've watched up until the end of the video. So thank you guys so much. But otherwise, if you did like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you would like to see more of me, then please consider a subscribe. But otherwise, as your girl Izuna once said, all good things must come to an end. And so thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.